friends, welcome to Import Export Federation. Welcome to Gulf Food. Here we are seeing a lot of Indian startups coming up with innovative products, good quality products, branded products, and we are very happy to see this kind of progress Indians are making. So we came across one such an innovative startup, Some More Foods. They are into food and packet food. You can see a lot of products are here. We'll meet the founder and understand from her what are these products you have here and how is the market is. Ma'am, welcome to Import Export Federation.
Thank you very much.
Please introduce your company and your product here.
Sure. I'm Deepa. I'm the founder of Some More Foods Private Limited. We are based out of Tamil Nadu. So we deal with millet products like noodles, millet pasta, gluten-free millet cookies, millet bites. Millet bites are extruded snacks that are made with millets. These are not oil-fried. These are baked. And when it comes to noodles, these are healthy noodles because these are again not oil fried, and we use millets and whole wheat flour. This is my first time participation in Gulf Food Expo. The feedback from the consumer is really good, and we are already exporting our products to Qatar, Bahrain, Dubai, and now we are looking for a potential partnership from across other countries also. Many people who visited our stall are showing interest to become our channel partners.
Please explain about this. What are the top selling products?
Yes,
and why they are top sellers?
So these are millet noodles. These are top selling products from our company. Okay. The reason is these days many mothers, they wanted to give healthy noodles to their kids, right? Maida noodles are not healthy. So we came up with a healthy option, offering them millets, noodles that are made with millets and wheat flour. We do not add maida in any of our products, and we do not add preservatives in any of our products. And in India, we are selling in many retail outlets like DMart, Reliance. We cracked the deal recently, and we are expecting to get our products next month. And we are there in Lulu stores pan India. We are there in Nesto stores, all the Kerala stores. And we are there in Max Hypermarket. We are there in Big Basket. This is our top selling product, and we have been getting very good feedback from our consumers, and we are supplying consistently to all the chain stores. And this is our gluten-free millet cookies. So as the name implies, these products are gluten-free, which means it does not have wheat or maida. And we have a very good response in UAE market. People who are allergic to gluten, who have a gluten intolerance, they prefer our products, and the taste is also very good. These are Hakka noodles. These are made with moringa leaves.
Moringa leaves.
Yes, we have incorporated a moringa leaves powder in the formulation, and this tastes very good. The challenge in these millets noodles is that it has to be tastier also, but we have cracked that, and we are able to scale very well in this segment.
How old is your company, ma'am?
Yes, it's been 10 years I started this. I started this for my son. It's just started with one product, which is a porridge mix.
Okay.
And as my son grew, I would say the company portfolio also grew.
It's a big journey, one decade, more than a decade.
Yeah,
and I think that's what I can see. I mean, you have made a lot of progress. I mean, such innovative product, different diversification you have done.
Certainly.
Right. So from where you get so much motivation, I mean, to do
yeah,
so much work?
Yeah, see, I would say like my son was the inspiration for me to venture into this. And as he grew up, like he was asking for noodles, then I thought, okay, I should not give noodles that is not healthy. And so the inspiration I get is I keep participating in lots of both national and international expos.
Okay.
So we connect with manufacturers in other sectors, and we get insights of what products is trending in the market. And for example, these days, Moringa and red rice noodles, along with the noodles, we have brought this cookies also to Gulf Food. This is a new product and we got it here. And
I heard first time cookies and noodles of Moringa. I mean, cookies, I heard powder, noodles, yes. Moringa powder, but these are the applications actually. And this is a very good example how you can produce your product and make it easy for people to buy actually.
Yeah, and this is again a new product that we have got for the Gulf Food. We are launching it here. And so based on the product feedback, we are working to explore to export to more other countries.
These are choco balls.
Yes.
So what are the ingredients of this?
Yes, we have added millets and this chocolate as a flavor we have added. We have,
okay.
So these are basically made with millets and we add, as you see in the back side, like we have added multiple millets and choco and cocoa powder as a flavoring agent.
Okay.
So, and for people who prefer butterscotch, we do have some flavors with butterscotch and we are coming up with other flavors as well.
Right.
So this has in India, like we tried with the sampling, we got very good feedback. So the same we wanted to try and check in the international market.
Right.
And that's why
these are all handmade or machine made?
This is handmade.
Okay.
Like laddus, like
nice.
We have to
exactly.
do it in the handmade. Yeah. So we are working on automation also. Like once we scale, we wanted to do an automated
so
process.
Currently, are you outsourcing all of the manufacturing?
Every product, we work with different manufacturers. Yeah, it is outsourced.
Okay.
Because I develop the product and we do with, manufacturing is done
but
with.
How easy is that to tackle so many people and get it as per your specification, quality, then packaging and then marketing that brand? Is it easy? I mean,
in the
was
beginning,
that easy for
yeah,
you?
Yeah. My journey, it's been, it's been a long journey. It's been 10 years and I'm working full time since 5 years. See, you need to be very innovative when it comes to product and innovation has to be there, not just in the product, but in marketing and strategies as well.
Yes.
I think we have done a very tremendous job in having innovation in marketing as well because we have built this resellers network during COVID. Like many homemakers, they buy our products with a little investment and they are able to sustain their business. We handhold them with the marketing skills that we have.
Right.
We help them to set up a sustainable business. So this model which we launched during COVID is having a great impact and we are also able to scale that as
you,
well.
You created or you have us associates across the country or out of the country also?
For now, this homemakers from South India, they are associated with us.
Okay.
To resell
through
our products.
Through some network?
Yeah, we have built that network.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, so in how you are marketing this in international market, because you already mentioned that you are exporting to 3-4 countries.
Yes.
So how did you find the buyer? How did you market this product?
Yes. So when we come and set up a stall here in Gulf Food, we get lots of inquiries. And so after completion of this Gulf Food Expo, I go and visit the stores directly and I check what kind of products is trending in the market. And I check with the man from whom they are buying, from which country they are buying. And I connect with the shopkeeper to connect with the distributors. And sometimes these distributors are willing to take our products and distribute in their supply chain.
Right.
So that is how we are able to crack it.
You do a lot of field work then. I mean, going to those prospects and marketing our products, sampling it, testing
yes.
it, getting feedback.
Yes.
So I think this kind of effort is required. I mean, many people in India just want to start a business, in a very comfort zone. They think that export is very easy. Create a product, market it online, digital, get the order, ship the product, get dollars. Is that so easy?
It is not at all easy. So first of all, we need to understand what the consumer needs.
Right.
And based on their needs, we have to come up with the products. And you need to work closely with the consumers. So what is their expectations
right.
and what kind of iterations can be made on the products to
right.
make it the best
right.
to meet their needs.
So let's say when it comes to Indian product like this, as you said, these are handmade laddus kind of thing.
Yes.
So how we are placed against the big companies who are giants in the market in this kind of products, why people will prefer this kind of product against them?
Yeah, that's a very good question. And it is similar to laddus that our grandmothers and mothers make at home. It's a homegrown brand. I mean, consumers love our brand, but it's similar to the laddus that like our parents, our mother or grandmother made it. And of course, they know the fact that these are not free of preservatives.
Right.
And the taste is also very good. So we customize products based on consumer needs, which a big brand cannot do.
Right. But is it then like only Indians are the potential buyers for these products?
See,
or
for
others
now,
are also buying?
For now, our focus is on Indian consumers because consumers from other countries, their choice of food products is totally different.
Mm.
So for now, we focus on Indians Indian who live in other countries.
Okay. So how is the response for this product in other part of India, apart from South, which is your hometown, let's say East or Western and Northern India?
Yes. There's a very good response because, as I previously said, we are on Big Basket Pan India. We are selling our products in Noida, Gurgaon. We've got amazing response. And recently, we got a few distributors in Delhi and they are selling our product. More than my expectation, the volume of our order is increasing.
Okay.
Which means consumers are welcoming this kind of products and there's a craving for these products. So when we provide these kind of products, the snacks, which is also healthier and also tastier. So I would say people are open to try new brands and once they try, they come back for our product.
When it comes to selling, you are selling it through modern trade, through the traditional distribution and through e-commerce also?
Yes. We have placed in all the many modern stores, as I said, Lulu, Nesto, Asp, Max Hypermarket and Reliance we cracked recently. And we are coming up with products for GT also. For example, if you take this noodles, this is 160 grams plus 15 grams masala. Now we are coming up with our 60 gram instant noodles, which will be for one serving and which will be priced less than 30 rupees. So we are planning to target GT market as well.
Okay.
And on e-commerce also, we have our own e-commerce site and we ship products pan India.
So when it comes to modern trade, I mean, it's very, you have to offer it at very competitive pricing and they expect a lot of offers, one-on-one, free and this kind of thing. So are you able to handle that economics?
Yes. It takes time for us to come to that break-even point, but for sure, as a brand, I feel it is... We should be present in across all the segments, omni channels, be it modern trade or GT or that's how you can increase the brand visibility because some consumers who come to modern trade will not go to GT and consumers who go to GT will not come to MT.
Yeah.
So as a part of brand building, it is mandatory to have products across all the chain stores is what I think.
You must have done a lot of investment for all this market development.
Yes.
So are you funded by any agency or any venture capitalist or you are doing this on your...
Thank you for asking this. In fact, I am very proud of this fact that I have not gone for external investors and this is a bootstrap venture with so much of a hard work, persistence and perseverance. I have come to this stage and I also support lots of aspiring women entrepreneurs who wants to be successful like me. So I would say every person's journey is different. Once you are very passionate and you have that persistence, what value you can add to your consumers, to the society, to the country is what will make a person feel satisfactory about the journey. That way, I would say, looking at my journey that I started 10 years back, it gives me a great satisfaction and still a long way to go.
Well, that's great. I think this is an ideal woman entrepreneur, I would say, the whole world will look at you and get inspiration. A lot of people, many women entrepreneurs also wish to start business or they want to start on their own, they want to be independent. You can see how much effort she has taken and right from product development till packaging, outsourcing, branding, marketing and international market is not easy at all. I can sense this, how much effort you must have put in.
Yeah.
So I really congratulate
you. Thank you very
you.
Much. And I also want to thank my friends who have been very supportive in the journey. It's not my journey alone. There are lots of good people, good hearted people who have helped me. In my journey.
Well,
so my thanks to all of them. I remember all of them when I come to participate in this international expo.
Yeah, great. So when you started export, how did you find your first export customer?
Yeah, that is a nostalgic moment for me also. So one of my customers came from Qatar to India, to Coimbatore, which was her native place. She brought our products and she went to many stores in Qatar checking with the shopkeepers whether the shopkeeper can bring our products to Qatar. Eventually, our consumers become our brand ambassadors.
Exactly. Yeah.
So that is how we got our first export order, which was during COVID. Mohammed from Qatar was our first buyer. I'm hoping to meet him sometime tomorrow.
Okay.
So he gave our first orders and that came through my consumer.
Exactly. That is the best thing which could happen to your business. Your consumer, your customer becomes your brand ambassador. And that's what grows real businesses. I wish you success, ma'am. Already you are successful.
Thank you very much, sir. It's very inspirational
to see all this journey and many of our associates in India and out of India in many other countries are looking forward to good products. I'm sure they will connect with you and start working on this product.
Sure. Definitely. Thank you very much, sir.
Well,
it was pleasant talking
people
to
people who are looking for good product. I think this is a very good product, good quality, good pricing. Founder herself is very innovative. It can be customized as per your geography, your need, your market need. And she has a lot of experience, I think. You know, she understands the market very well. So definitely, this is a good opportunity for all of us. Thank you all. I wish you success, ma'am.
Thank you.